and he has just come up from a record-breaking gig at the Point Theatre, and he's come to sing us a song and have a little word with us. Would you welcome, please, from Oasis and the Point, Noel Gallagher. Noel Gallagher. Here you go. How are you? Thanks very much for coming.
Thanks very much indeed for coming. Give us a little song there, please, and you will.
Thank you.
Very good. Terrific.
Thank you very much. This one's called Wonderwall. Today was gonna be the day they were gonna throw it back to you. By now you should have somehow realized what you got to do. I don't believe that anybody feel the way I do about you now. A backbeat, the word is on the street that the fire in your heart went out. And I'm sure you've heard it all before, but you never really had a doubt. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. And all the roads we have to walk are winding, and all the lights that light the way are blinding. There are many things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know how. Said I don't know how. Said maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me. And after all, you're my Wonderwall. Today was gonna be the day, but they'll never throw it back to you. By now you should have somehow realized what you're not to do. I don't believe that anybody feel the way I do about you now. And all the roads we have to walk are winding, and all the lights that light the way are blinding, they're blinding. There are many songs that I would like to sing to you, but I don't know how. I said I don't know how. And I said maybe you're gonna be the one who saves me. And after all, you're my Wonderwall. And I said, maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me. And after all, you're my Wonderwall. And I said, maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me. Gonna be the one that saves me. You're gonna be the one that saves me. Thank you very much.
How are you? Great to have you with us. Come on and sit down. Right. We're running to, we'll run to 45 at least, Ray, if you clear that for me. How did the Point go tonight, then? Yeah.
It was, we didn't hear a word that we could sing. We didn't hear a word we played because the crowd was singing that loud. So we don't really know yet. But judging by the crowd's reaction, it was just, I think it's one of the best gigs we've ever played, I think.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
One
it's just,
best?
Oh, easily. The crowd, I mean, it's the crowd that makes a show for us because we don't usually do that much on stage. We sort of just stand around and play the music. And if the crowd are up for it, then we are. And, let's just say they were mad for it tonight.
Yeah. When did you start playing?
I started messing about when I was about six, so I'm told, I believe.
Seriously, when I was about 14, 13 or 14.
Got your first guitar?
Well, there was always one lying around the house. I think my dad had one.
Yeah.
So I was just sort of picked it up and just sort of messing about, just playing one string and then two strings and then got on to six.
Yeah.
And then started taking it seriously I was useless at everything else, so I thought this is the only thing that I'm good at, so I just decided to take up the guitar as a career move.
Yeah. And did you learn from a book or did you get lessons?
No, I'm left-handed, so I should play guitar left-handed, but I play it right-handed. Yeah. I can't read or write music. I can't even spell my name, to be quite honest.
What do you mean?
Come on. No, I'm only joking.
You can't put down dots.
No, I don't know. I don't know any of that. I don't even know the chords when I'm playing it. I mean, I've met all the guitarists who are versed in reading and writing music, and they reckon it's a blessing, I suppose.
I see.
And
what do you do? Put it on tape then?
Yeah, just stick it onto like little tape recorders and just play it back until I'm happy with it, and then deliver it to the chaps.
Right, and they put the dots on it.
Yeah, well, Christopher Berg does the same.
Does he?
Yeah, he does. He says he bangs it. He can't annotate the music. So there you are. I'm sorry for mentioning that name in the same sort of context, but there you are. He does pretty well. Fantastic. How are you coping with the transition from 2 years ago? Really, it's happened so fast.
We've not had time to sit down and think about it. I suppose if we actually sat down and thought about what's happened over the last 2 years, we'd probably be in the big house, as my nana says.
Mm.
But it's like we're just too busy working and too busy sort of in sort of the eye of the hurricane is where the calmest point probably is. It's like, I mean, tonight when we were going to the gig, we had to have a police escort, and all around the car was just little kids' faces. So I was more nervous for them in case they got run over than I was for me in case they got hold of me.
Yeah. Yeah. And how are you coping with that now?
Well, I'm quite lucky to have sort of a great family and a great bunch of friends around who are if they find that you might be getting ideas above your station and start maybe being a bit big-headed and believing your own press, that they'll sort of take you to one side and remind you where you came from. So I suppose that is a great leveller.
But the problem is you can't go anywhere now. I mean, it's the biggest band, as I said, on the planet, as they say.
But there's nowhere to go. I've been everywhere.
Do you have to have bodyguards? Do you have to have people around you all the time?
Actually, I gave mine the slip the other night, and I went out for a drink on my own in Dublin. He was most nervous.
Yes.
But see, the thing is, if you go out and you make a big deal about all going out together, and there's hundreds of you, you're going to sort of make a big scene. And like, I mean, I went out the other night, I just went on my own. You know, it was a pub on Leeson Street.
Yeah.
And I just sat in there for like 2 hours and nobody knew who I was.
Nobody?
Well, the barman did, but I made him promise that he wouldn't say anything, so I put some of his mates on the guest list for tonight. I said, come on, mate, just let's have a drink.
Yeah. And you bought him off, in other words.
I did, yeah, I bribed him, yeah.
Bought him off. Yeah. And nobody recognised you?
No. Well, a few people did, but there was like thinking, it can't be him, he can't be here on his own, so they were just going, nah, he must just look like him.
Yeah, drinking a pint.
Yeah, that was it.
Great. Yeah. The only reason you're on The Late Show, of course, is because your mother.
Is that right?
Told you, yeah.
Yeah, she did.
Where's mum? Sorry, I beg your pardon, sorry. Your mother told you to be on The Late Show, didn't she?
She did. I asked her permission, would it be all right to go on, and she made it, she made me go on.
Absolutely.
She's actually up at the pint, in the bar. At the moment, still.
And where's young Liam? Where would he be at the moment?
Liam will be in the after-show party, holding court, and the rest of the band will be listening. And Liam will be doing all the talking.
Yes.
And here am I working.
Yeah, that's right. Don't worry, as your mother would say, you'll get your reward in heaven. God will reward you for coming to The Late Late Show, there's no doubt about it. You said that none of the others can write a crotchet or quaver, for God's sake. You do all the work.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Do you feel badly about that?
I feel overjoyed at the fact that I have to write all the songs because...
Are they just bone lazy or something, is it?
Well, yeah. Basically, I think they must have been spoiled as children.
Yeah.
That's what I reckon, anyway.
And they just do nothing?
Well, they drink and shout a lot and cause trouble, and that's about it, really.
Yeah.
But you
have a hard job.
I'm the quiet one, you see.
That's right. You're the older brother, and you keep them all in line. I can't see you. The chap in the front row. Yeah. I beg your pardon. Couldn't see you. Sorry.
I just wanted to ask. How long do you see it lasting?
As long as it lasts. I don't think you can predict the future or anything like that, and I wouldn't want to. I suppose the Beatles, I mean, if you look back at all the interviews on the Beatles, they all said, oh, well, we'll probably won't be anywhere in 10 months. And they all wanted to own hairdressing salons. And I mean, and the Beatles are still going, so this day after 30 years, they're still releasing records. So I just hope it lasts for as long as I enjoy it. And then if I'm not enjoying it, I hope somebody will give me the sack.
And is it right what Gay says, you use a tape machine if you can't write music? You...
Yeah, just sort of like, just little Walkmans and stuff, you know.
And do you ever freak out about drying up?
What do you mean, like, not
just
going to the
another
pub?
Song won't
I do actually, yeah. I think it's an ongoing concern of artists anyway. Just if you got up one day and weren't able to write a song, I suppose that's your sort of, that's your lifeblood gone. But you could always go to the pub and drown your sorrows, though, couldn't
you? That's true.
Absolutely.
What about the pressures of that? How do you feel about the pressures of you know, I've got to get 12 songs out next year? Or...
Yeah. It's hard work. But, I mean, it's not as hard as some of the jobs I've had. Yeah. But it's hard work, you know. So I suppose you just take it as it comes. Right?
Listen, this guy was on a building site 3 years ago.
Best of luck, anyway.
Building site 3 years ago, yeah. Well, and now, are you driving the Rolls Royce, or have you just got the Rolls Royce?
I got given the Rolls Royce, and I refuse to learn to drive it. Because, I mean, I'd just be too busy looking out the window, I'd crash it.
where's the roller now as we speak?
The Rolls Royce is only brought out for official functions. And
somebody else drives it.
And a mate of mine called Simon, hello Simon, is he's the official chauffeur of the Holy Roller.
I see. And you were given this by the record company, wasn't it?
Yeah, I was given it by the record company for Christmas.
Well done.
Which makes me think I must be making them a serious amount of money, and I can't wait to see what I get next Christmas.
Well done. Good thinking. Yeah, who is that young fella? Sorry, I beg your pardon. How are you? There's all sorts of people want to talk to you now. Yeah. Hi.
How you doing, Noel?
All right, you look like the drummer out of Suede. Has anyone ever told you that?
Yeah.
You do?
No, nobody said that.
All right.
Love your music. I think it's great.
Thanks a lot.
Congratulations on your success. It's just we know who's possibly your greatest fan. Her name's Tracy Keevans. And if she knows that you're here tonight and we didn't tell you about her, she'd kill us. So
all right.
You can say hello to her, and we're going to your gig tomorrow
all
night.
All right, definitely. Look forward to it. Hello, Tracy.
Whatever you want.
Hi, Tracy. Thanks a million.
All right, Tracy.
Well, we weren't absolutely certain. We weren't absolutely certain he was coming until much later. Hi there. Yeah. Hello.
Hi. I've always wanted to say I think yourself you should be the lead singer in the band. I really.
This wasn't a plant, Liam.
I love the band. No, but what I wanted to say was yourself and Blur, the elf in the pop media these days. You seem to be, I don't know, at loggerheads. But I don't believe that myself. I believe behind the scenes you are good mates.
No comment on that.
Blur are lovely boys.
How Irish do you reckon you are?
I'm half. Because I was born and raised in Manchester, but my mother
from
Charlestown in County Mayo.
Yeah, and my dad from
Dalek in Meath. So that makes me exactly half. Although which half it is?
Indeed.
No.
So you were back in Charlestown a lot, though, were you not?
We used to have 6 weeks holidays in England for the school summer. My mum used to religiously drag us by the ear hole across the Irish Sea for 6 weeks. Because we'd never seen the likes of nettles and fields and stacks of hay and all that, and she was determined to give us a bit of Irish culture because we were used to like concrete and flats and stuff, and it was a bit of a culture shock for about the first 4 or 5 years, but we just grew to love it, you know. I mean, I still do to this day. And the great thing the other day was when we came in for the airport, you know that smell that's in the air when the turf's burning. It's like as soon as you smell that, it's like almost brings a tear to your eye. You know, it just reminds you of your childhood.
When were you last there, down there, Charlestown?
I was last down in Charlestown. Wasn't that long ago? I think it was only about a year and a half ago.
Mm.
Yeah, I was just down, driving around.
But you won't find peace there now either, you see.
But you will.
Will you?
Yeah, you will. So we bought all the people in the town.
What does the mammy think of when she reads about all the carry-on between yourself and the band and Liam and all of that?
She does, you know, she sort of... She'll sort of summon us to the house for a Sunday dinner, and she'll sit with a copy of the NME under the chair.
The NME,
and whatever paper we've been carrying on in.
Yes.
And then and then she'll feed us up, and then she'll go, right then. what was this you said about him? And I'm like, me and I could be going, it wasn't me, it was him, he said it about me. And then she, you know, clap around the ear and stuff like that. And then she puts the kettle on, it's all forgotten about. But she loves us, really. She just knows we're a lovable rogues.
Of course she does. But and she's
you
she's,
do, don't you, man?
She's proud of you.
You do love us, don't you?
She's proud of you as well.
Oh, absolutely. Well, she
rejoices.
Yeah, she travels to see us when she can, and she's up at the point as we speak.
Yeah.
Like I say, she's probably... She actually got voted in a magazine in England, Mother of the Year, or something. Which she was most chuffed about.
I presume most of what is written about you in the newspapers is false. I presume half of it is.
It's 60% true, 40% blatant lies.
Yes. Do you mean the drugs and the drink and the carry-on and the belting each other and all that?
Yeah.
60% is true.
Yeah.
I see. So you're only...
No comment.
Go and take your guitar. I really must thank you because you must be worn out. Are you really worn out?
Tired,
you're very tired.
Thank you.
Just one other number and you'll be very, very welcome. Thank you. Okay. Thank you.
Maybe I don't really want to know how your garden grows, 'cause I just want to fly. You said lately, did you ever feel the pain of the morning rain as it soaks you to the bone? Maybe I just want to fly, want to live but don't want to die. Maybe I just want to breathe, maybe I just don't believe. Maybe you're the same as me, we see things they'll never see. You and I, we're gonna live forever. Said maybe, I don't really want to know how your garden grows, 'cause I just want to fly. Lately, did you ever feel the pain in the morning rain as it soaks you to the bone? Maybe I will never be all the things that I'd like to be, but now is not the time to cry, and now's the time to find out why. I feel you're the same as me, we see things they'll never see. You and I, we're gonna live forever. To the bone. Maybe I just want to fly, I want to live but don't want to die. Maybe I just want to breathe, maybe I just don't believe. Maybe you're the same as me, we see things they'll never see. You and I, we're gonna live forever.
Thanks a lot.
Well done. well done. Okay, hold it a moment, folks. Our very, very sincere thanks to you for coming tonight. I know you've had a fantastic show. You must be worn out, but it was a great pleasure to have you. And Peggy, that's the mammy.
That's the mammy.
Peggy, thank you very much indeed for your recommendation. Without you, it wouldn't have happened. Okay, so good night. God bless you. I'll see you next week. Goodbye.
Late Show.